they will hand you over to courts and scourge you in their synagogues, and you will be led before governors and kings for my sake as a witness before them and the pagans. When they hand you over, do not worry about how you are to speak or what you are to say, for it will not be you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Brother will hand over brother to death, and the father his child. Children will rise up against parents and have them put to death. You will be hated by all because of my name. But whoever endures to the end will be saved. When they persecute you in one town, flee to another. Amen, I say to you, you will not finish with the towns of Israel before the Son of Man comes. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In our first reading today from the prophet Hosea, we get a good piece of advice. Return to the Lord, your God. Return to the Lord, your God. How appropriate that we hear that as we gather, in fact, in the church, as we come back to God each and every morning in the celebration of the Eucharist, to hear God's word, to be strengthened by it, to be challenged by it, for sure, and to be fed and strengthened by Jesus' body and blood, and sent forth again, as we hear in our gospel, to make the proclamation of God's kingdom. Perhaps you have had experience as an employee when the boss seems to increase your responsibilities. You think to yourself that maybe saying to someone else, but why don't you say to the boss, I didn't sign up for that. Or perhaps those of you who are supervisors and bosses, administrators, sometimes without thinking that we are adding additional burdens to someone, we might encourage, invite, request additional responsibilities of them. In fact, some contracts are written in such a way that it doesn't require the employer to list every single thing that's expected of the employee. It's these and whatever else is kind of thrown your way. And when you think about the disciples, and what Jesus says in the gospel today, it would be okay for them, I think, to say, hey, I didn't sign up for this, for the persecution, and being scourged, and led before kings and governors, and even put to death. I didn't sign up for that. I signed up to be a fisher of men and women, to be a proclaimer of good news. But Jesus assures us that even in those difficult times, even in those moments of persecution, even those moments of great stress, the Spirit of the Lord is upon us and is with us. And in fact, so powerfully present in our lives, we don't have to worry about our defense in the name of Jesus. Just trust that God, through the gift of the Spirit, gives us the words, the courage, the strength, the wisdom, Giuliani, the wonderful Capuchin Saint Clare nun. She was gifted by receiving the sacred stigmata of the wounds of Jesus, but furthermore, she also received the wounds of the crown of thorns on her head. And even when she felt tremendous suffering, and in her autobiography, one of her letters, she writes how she spent many nights rejoicing, thanking God that she was counted worthy to bear the marks of the Savior. I have to ask myself, what am I willing to endure? salvation and that of the world. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you and your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to This is Jesus, who sends us out to proclaim the kingdom. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into thy home, but only my spirit and my soul is healed.
Thank you.
living images of Christ, who sacrificed himself for the salvation of the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.